Hi students of class 12. In this video, you'll be learning about hemoglobin based genetic disorders, sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. So the two hemoglobin based disorders are sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. Before learning these disorders, you should learn about the structure of normal hemoglobin. So here you can see the quaternary structure of hemoglobin. Each hemoglobin consists of two parts, an iron porphyrin group, the heme, and a globin protein. The globin protein has four polypeptide chains, two alpha chains, and two beta chains. And each chain is linked to a heme group. So here you can see the two alpha chains, then the two beta chains, and these are the four heme groups, each group linked to a polypeptide. In sickle cell anemia, the hemoglobin B gene undergoes a specific mutation and results in a defective hemoglobin, and thereby the red blood cells become sickle shaped and gets destroyed easily, causing anemia. Now coming to the sickle cell anemia, the mutated gene is located in the autosomes. I already mentioned that. In sickle cell anemia, a gene, HBB gene, undergoes mutation. As a result, a defective hemoglobin is produced, and thereby the red blood cells become sickle shaped and gets destroyed easily, causing anemia. So the mutated gene is located in the autosomes and not in the sex chromosome. And also the gene is recessive and can be expressed only in the homozygous condition. So sickle cell anemia is an autosomal recessive trait. Why do you call sickle cell anemia as an autosomal recessive trait? The mutated gene are located in the autosomes and not in the sex chromosome. And also the gene is a recessive gene. Only in the homozygous recessive condition the disease can be expressed. The mutation is due to a single base pair change in the DNA, and the mutation is called point mutation. A single base pair change occurs, and that mutation is the point mutation. So here you can see the normal case and here the sickle cell anemic individual. In the normal case, it is seen that the base pairs of the two strands are GAG and CTC. These are the nitrogenous bases, guanine, adenine, thymine, cytosine. So in the normal case, the DNA base pairs of the two strands are GAG and CTC. And this DNA, one of the strands of the DNA can synthesize an RNA. So CTC, the complementary bases in the RNA are GAG. And GAG codes for the amino acid glutamic acid. This is a normal condition. Now what happens in sickle cell anemia? The DNA base pairs are GTG and CAC, because the adenine of the normal gene is replaced by thymine. So once thymine is here, the complementary base is adenine. So this is a base pair that has undergone mutation. Now the mRNA that is synthesized from this DNA is GUG. Cytosine, complementary bases, guanine. For adenine, there is no thymine in RNA. Instead, you have to write a uracil. And for cytosine, guanine. So this is the RNA that is synthesized, GUG. And this GUG is not coding for glutamic acid. GUG codes for the amino acid valine. So this is a mutant protein. This is what is happening in sickle cell anemia. The beta chain of the hemoglobin, a mutation takes place. As a result, the sixth amino acid of the beta chain, normally it is glutamic acid, but it is replaced by valine. So that is what is given here. The defect is caused by the substitution of glutamic acid by valine at the sixth position of the beta globin chain of the hemoglobin molecule. So here you can see the beta globin chain of hemoglobin molecule. The normal hemoglobin, the beta globin chain, the sixth amino acid is the glutamic acid. Whereas in sickle cell anemic people, the sixth amino acid is valine and not glutamic acid. Now what are the genotype of the individuals. Normal individuals have the genotype HbA HbA. Sickle cell anemic individuals have the genotype HbS HbS. Whereas the carriers are heterozygous HbA HbS. Only if both the partners are heterozygous HbA HbS, sickle cell anemic individuals can be produced. So here you can see a cross between two individuals, both the partners are carriers. So HbA HbS produce two types of gametes, some gametes carrying HbA and some gametes carrying HbS. Similarly, the other partner also, some gametes are HbA and some gametes are HbS. On fertilization, what happens is when HbA and HbA, you get a normal individual. HbA, HbS will produce a heterozygous individual. HbS, HbA also produce a heterozygous individual. And HbS, HbS, a sickle cell disease person will be produced. So you can see the phenotypes are unaffected are there, carriers are there, and sickle cell anemic people are there. And the phenotypic ratio is 1 HbA, HbA is to 2 HbA, HbS is to 1 HbS, HbS. So the disease can be transmitted from parent to the offspring only if both the partners are carriers for the gene HbA, HbS. Out of the three possible genotypes which I had already mentioned, only homozygous individuals show the diseased phenotype, whereas heterozygous individuals will act as carriers of the disease. Now the symptoms of sickle cell anemia are, here you can see a healthy red blood cell which is biconcave and a sickle cell RBC which is sickle shaped. And this sickle shaped RBC will block the blood flow and this results in anemia. Another hemoglobin based disorder is the thalassemia. Like sickle cell anemia, thalassemia is also an autosomal linked recessive disorder. Means that mutated gene is located in the autosomes and not in the sex chromosome. Also, the gene is a recessive gene. Only in the homozygous condition the disease will be expressed. And also, both the parents should be heterozygous to produce a thalassemic individual. Now, this thalassemia are of two types, alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia. Now, what are the differences between alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia? Alpha thalassemia is controlled by two closely linked genes, HBA1 and HBA2 on chromosome 16 of each parent. Whereas beta thalassemia is controlled by a single gene, HBB, on chromosome 11. In alpha thalassemia, production of alpha globin chain is affected, whereas in beta thalassemia, production of beta globin chain is affected. So the defect is due to mutation or deletion of a gene which results in reduced rate of synthesis of one of the globin chains that make up the hemoglobin. Now the differences between thalassemia and sickle cell anemia are, thalassemia is a quantitative disorder, sickle cell anemia is a qualitative disorder. Why you say it as quantitative disorder? Because this disorder results in the synthesizing of too few globin molecules. Whereas in sickle cell anemia, this disorder results in an incorrectly functioning globin protein. So that is all what you have to learn in this topic. Hope all of you have enjoyed this video. If so, click like, comment and subscribe. And for detailed notes, visit my website www.ranipradeep.com. Thank you.